presence of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Amen. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Welcome to our service today. A special welcome, but a quiet welcome to Paige, who's fast asleep for her baptism. So welcome to you and your family today. Would everyone like to please be seated? So as I said, our service today is a very happy occasion because we've got a baptism. Hopefully you can all see one of our service sheets. Yours might be yellow, don't panic, they're the same. Some are yellow, some are white. I don't know if anyone's got any other colours. But hopefully they've got this picture on the front, they're what we are looking at. It should follow through, hopefully quite smoothly. The bits in the dark type, the bold type, are for everybody to join in with, please, unless I mention otherwise. Just a couple of things to remind people of. When we are moving around the church, so that means when you get up and get out, okay, please can you keep your face masks on? And when we are singing, can we put the face masks on as well? But when you're seated, that is up to you, okay? Halfway through the service, we celebrate what we call Holy Communion. You will be invited to come forward by church representatives, so please wait till you're invited to do so, because we're trying to keep, you know, a bit of a system so we're not on top of one another, and we do go up towards the altar, and I ask people to remain standing. If you're used to receiving the bread in any of the churches, then please do put your hands forward. If you are not, you are welcome to come forward for a blessing. Please either hold a service sheet or a hymn book, or keep your arms crossed, and everyone's welcome and invited to come forward and receive God's blessing today. We're going to start now, it's called a collect, this prayer, and that's because the prayer collects all of our thoughts together for today's service. So we just have a moment quiet before we have this prayer together. Let us pray. God of constant mercy, who sent your Son to save us, remind us of your goodness. Increase your grace within us, that our thankfulness may grow through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And we're going to have our first Bible reading for today.
A reading from the letter to the Ephesians, chapter 6. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armour of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armour of God, so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and have done everything to stand firm. Stand therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist, and put on the breastplate of righteousness. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all of these, take the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times, in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always preserve in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak a message, may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly as I must speak. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. We're going to sing now. I'm hoping it's one that most of us are familiar with. It's in the red hymn book that you should have picked up on the way in, number 638. Give me joy in my heart, keep me praising. We do put our face masks on to sing, and we do stand to sing hymn number 638. Journey, and that's a bag, okay? Depends where you're going, how big your bag might be, This for me would probably be an afternoon journey. I don't pack lightly, okay? I haven't got everything today, but you know, we all take a bag, don't we, on a journey. I need some things in my bag. You can see my bag is completely empty, and I thought we'd have a think about some of the things that we take on a journey. I've only brought a few things with me today, so don't panic. I've not got my whole wardrobe with me. But I did wonder if some people could help me pack my bag. Now, I've only got a few items, so I only need a few helpers. And I have to say, if anyone does volunteer to help and come all the way up and stand with me, we have got the camera on. We are live streaming to Facebook and YouTube. So if you come stand near me, you're going to be, you know, an internet star, basically, which is fine with me, but if you don't fancy doing that, then just don't put your hand up, okay? Because we can't turn it on and off, okay? And I also will say that all the items I've brought with me have not been touched for 72 hours. This morning I moved them to church wearing disposable gloves, so it should be okay for everyone to touch them. Does anyone want to help me find one item to pack into my bag? Anyone brave enough to come forward and find one item? Zachary, you have your hand up quite quick. Do you want to come forward and help me see what we might put in my bag? I've only got a few items, and if you look at them and choose which one you think I might want to take with me, they're just here, they're hiding here. If you could pick one thing up, what do you fancy picking up from that pile? Do you want to hold it high? It's a very small one. Do you know what that is? Can you see what that is? Brilliant. Pop it in there. Do you know what I'd use a torch for? Brilliant, thank you. Do you want to sit down again? So, Zachary has put in my bag a torch, okay? And they are quite useful to take on a journey, particularly, I don't know if you're one of the people who go prepared and you keep one in your car, in case you suddenly, I don't know, you're in the dark and you need to see. And with baptism, we don't have a torch, we have a candle. But it's for the same reason, it's for light. You will see at the front here, we've got this great big candle, the Easter candle, or the Paschal candle at school. We actually have a special service at Easter to bless this candle, and we've lit it today to remind us that God's blessing is with us. Later today, we're going to give Paige a candle as well. It is not that big, so don't worry. And also, I won't give it just to you, Paige, because I'm really not quite sure what on earth you'll do with it, but it will be yours one day, okay? And we will light it from this candle, a symbol of God's blessing. And it's a symbol that God's blessing, with Paige today at her baptism, will stay with her as she journeys through life. And that's a nice thing to remember for all of us who are baptised, that God's blessing stays with us as we move, as we journey through life. And this symbolism of light is just a symbolism of all good things, of love and goodness and all those amazing things. Does anyone else want to help me find something I might need for a journey? Anyone else brave enough to come to the front? I might have to pick an adult, no one comes forward. Come on, Nigel, you can find something for me. Sorry. I warned you, Mike said no. What have you found? Hold
yeah,
it,
I think you generally need that rather a lot.
I do, thank you, yes. I go a lot of places I don't know, actually, when people ask me to visit them, which is great. So I've put a map in my bag. Hands up, who actually owns a map these days, a paper map? Oh, the people at the back do, brilliant, and one or two others, excellent. Hands up, who uses a sat nav, whether on your phone or anything like that? Yeah, great. Okay, that's brilliant. So sometimes people use a map, like I've got here. Sometimes people use a sat nav. I always have this map with me, actually, because I seem to end up in places where I've got no signal. So even if I'm using my sat nav, then it doesn't work at the moment I need it. But we need a map to show us where to go if we're going on a journey. If we might get lost and we need to know where to go. It gives us directions. When we're thinking about a baptism, if we were to have one of these sat navs, we wouldn't type in a postcode. Instead of the postcode, we'd type in the word God, you know, or we might type in the word love. At a baptism, that is what we are orientating ourselves towards. We're saying, yes, we want to follow God's way. Yes, we want to do things that are loving. When we have our physical map, we get lost, we get it out, it shows us which way to go. When we're thinking in a Christian sense, people use all sorts of things to help direct them. They might use the Bible, that helps direct us which way to go in their life. They might have conversations with other Christians. all sorts of things, but our sat-nav is kind of orientated towards God, towards love. And that's the journey that Paige is starting today. Zachary, do you want to find something else for me, please? You'll help me, won't you? Oh, thank you very much. That's great. See what else you can find for us that I need on my journey. Oh, hold that up so everyone can see it. Is it heavy? What is it? Okay. Yeah, brilliant. Thank you. So, a drink bottle, some water. Very handy to have something to drink if you're going on a long journey, isn't it? In your bag, you have some water. And we all know that we need water, don't we, to keep us alive. We have to drink water. And, you know, here at Paige today, we're celebrating her life. And celebrating her life as a child of God. Now, when I go on a journey these days, I've got a young child, and sometimes she gets messy, and I end up using the water I'm going to drink to clean her with, okay? And, you know, we do, we use water to wash. And when we're going to have the baptism prepared, we're thinking about washing. We're not literally going to get out the soap and do all of that, but we're thinking about washing away sins. And we do look at Paige and we think, you know, you look lovely. We don't think you've ever done anything wrong or given anyone a sleepless night or anything like that. Parents might disagree. But really, the point is, she hasn't made any decisions, has she? You know, she's too little. But when she gets older, sorry to tell you, but I'm sure you realise she'll make her own decisions, and sometimes she's going to make the ones you wish she hadn't made. We all make decisions. We think, why have we done that? We regret it. We make the wrong decisions. At baptism, we're washed clean from the sins, from the bad things that we end up doing. So this symbol of water and washing will stay with Paige throughout her life, that she'll know she's forgiven by God. And actually, it's a symbol we can all take. Whether we've been baptized or not, we can always come to God and ask for his forgiveness. I've got one more item. Paige, are you able to come forward, please? You'll like this last one, Kate. I'm sure you will. Yeah, I knew you'd like that. What have you got there? Hold it up for everyone. Thank you. So in there. Great. So, a teddy bear. Hands up, who has a teddy bear? I bet some adults still have one, if you're honest. Yeah? Brilliant. Hands down. I think more of you have that than put your hands up. A teddy bear. The reason I've got a teddy bear is because it gives you a bit of company. You know? And I couldn't actually bring in my bag the people I would take on my journey, my family or my friends. And that's who we do often go on journeys with. We often don't go on our own. And Paige's baptism, she's got some special people on the journey with her. As well as the parents, she's got her godparents. And they are all about this journey. They're not just here to say, hello, I want to look lovely on the photos for today. They're here to say that they want to journey with Paige as she moves through life. They want to be a constant, positive example in her life. And that's what it's about. And also, as well as having godparents, I think we've got all the Christian community, we've got one another to offer support. We all need some company. I've actually got one last thing that I deliberately wanted to keep till last that I take on a journey. Hands up, who takes some snacks on a journey? Does anyone take snacks on a journey? Yeah, that's the one most people seem to put their hand up. Okay, that's great. I've bought some snacks that I take. I like to take chocolate, okay? Basically, I take chocolate anywhere, okay? But particularly on a journey. And I bought these chocolates on purpose because they say celebrations. Yeah? And life is about joy. Baptism is about joy, about celebrating. We're celebrating your life, Paige. And I always think a celebration needs a bit of chocolate, okay? The journey of life needs a bit of chocolate. So at the very end, what I'm going to do is, I've not opened this yet, is I am going to open these and we can share them, okay? But what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of scatter them in a nice way in the porch, so you just pick up one rather than everybody's hands rummaging through. I'm relying on you all to know if you've got any allergies not to have that one, okay? But, you know, we are here to celebrate as well as all these other important things that we do when we think about baptism and think about our journey of life and faith. Amen. And I think you've probably done enough looking at me for one moment, and now Paige is awake. Do Mum and Dad want to bring Paige to the front, please? Yeah, we want to look at you now. So I just thought it'd be really nice if we could all have a good look at Paige. Can you wave? She won't wave. Can you wave? Only when you feel like it, yeah. We all have those days, don't we? Could you remind everybody her full name, please?
Paige Olivia Daisy King.
And how old is she now?
11 months.
11 months, wow.
You'll have a birthday soon.
You will. Yeah, and you look great. Is that a brand new dress? Yeah, you look lovely. Did I ask what kind of thing she wants doing?
Anything and everything.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's going to keep you on your toes. Then anything and everything. Busy girl. I like that. I like to hear that. Good. Now, we've got some special prayers for you.
We have.
Yeah, and so you're going to stay there so everyone can look at you.
If everyone turns back to their service sheets, we're on page 2. It's a prayer of welcome. So I think it's really nice and important if we can see Paige when we're welcoming her. And I'd love everybody to join in with this prayer, please, when we get to the bit in the bowl time. Faith is the gift of God to his people. In baptism, the Lord is adding to our number those whom he is calling. People of God, will you welcome this child and uphold her in her new life in Christ?
With the help of God, we will.
Now, I've mentioned that godparents having a special role already. Could they please stand up wherever they are? That's wonderful. Can all godparents stand up? Great. Wonderful. I've got now some special promises, which are just for the people who have stood up. So the bits in the bowl type are just for the people who stood up. Can I give this one to you too? So we're halfway down page 2. Parents and godparents, the church receives this child with joy, and today we're trusting God for her growth in faith. Will you pray for her? Draw her by your example into the community of faith and walk with her in the way of Christ. In baptism, this child begins her journey in faith, and you speak for her today. Will you care for her and help her to take her place within the worship of Christ's church? In baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvellous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with him. Therefore, I ask, do you turn to Christ? Do you repent of your sins? Do you renounce evil? Okay, that's great. So, godparents can sit down now. Well done. Paige, you stay there 1 minute because I am going to make a special sign on your forehead. It's the sign of the cross. Are you waving now? Look at the other. The sign of the cross. Are you wearing the cross as well? Oh, lovely. So you know already, don't you? That is the symbol of the Christian faith. And I'm going to put it on the symbol on your head with some special oil. And this oil has been blessed. It has, yeah, it's been blessed, yeah. And the bits now, we're halfway down page 3. All the rest of the time now in the service, the bits in bold are for everybody to join in with, please. So I'm going to make the sign of the cross, and then we'll have these special prayers, Paige. Paige Olivia Daisy, Christ claims you for his own. Receive the sign of the cross. Do not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified. Fight valiantly as a disciple of Christ against sin, the world and the devil, and remain faithful to Christ to the end of your life. And may Almighty God deliver you from the powers of darkness, restoring you the image of his glory, and lead you in the light and obedience of Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Well done. That wiggle made it the biggest cross we'd ever had. Well done, Paige. That's great. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get to the baptism itself. We do move over to the font, which is by the main door for this part of the service. I'm going to ask
Olivia and her family to follow me, and the godparents to follow me as well. If everybody else stands up and looks that way, then hopefully we'll all be able to see what we're doing. Just come behind you to get my mic. Now.
Elizabeth, can you make sure it's pointing in the right direction?
Our next hymn, number 757, One More Step Along the World I Go. So again, we're back in our red hymn books, our face masks on, and standing as we sing hymn number 757.
Thank you.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Almighty God, good Father to us all, your face is turned towards your world. In love you gave us Jesus, your Son, to rescue us from sin and death. Your word goes out to call us home to the cities where angels sing your praise. We join with them in heaven's song.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Father of all, we give you thanks for every gift that comes from heaven. To the darkness, Jesus came as your light, with signs of faith and words of hope. He touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean.
This is his story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
The crowds came out to see your Son, yet at the end they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people.
This is his story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Jesus blessed you, Father, for the food. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body, given for you all." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, gave it and said, "This is my blood, shed for you all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me."
This is our story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which he died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again and is alive with you to plead for us and all the world.
This is our story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Send your Spirit on us now, that by these gifts we may feed on Christ with opened eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, where all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us.
Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us.
Jesus, Redeemer of the world,
grant us peace.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word,
and ours shall be you.
The blessing and honor of God, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of all mercy, in this Eucharist you have set aside our sins and given us your healing. Grant that we who are made whole in Christ may bring that healing to this broken world. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And we're going to stand to sing our final hymn for today, which is number 719, Shine, Jesus, Shine. That's hymn number 719. Day to sign up for our Sing School. It's particularly aimed at children in primary school to come and enjoy singing together, to learn a bit about singing and the basics, and just to have some fun together and make some new friends. It's going across 4 mornings at the last week of the school holidays. If you want a bit more information, you want to chat to someone to find out what's involved, Kate's here today to have a bit of a chat with you if you would like to find out a bit more. Otherwise, there are all the details on the website and how to sign up, so I encourage you to do so if you haven't already. A reminder looking to the future, our Garden Fete is on Saturday the 11th of September, so do pop that in your diaries in the afternoon. We're still looking for a volunteer, one or two, to coordinate collecting prizes for the tombola and raffle from the local businesses and the streets. We're really, really in need of someone to volunteer to do that, please, because it's a really vital role and, you know, time's upon us and we haven't had any kind person coming forward yet. So if you're half thinking about it, please can I encourage you to give it the other half of thought. And the last thing to mention is Greenbelt. We are having a Greenbelt at Home Day. So it's a kind of a day event where we're worshipping together. We've got a talk, a film, a discussion, some practical activities, some food, including fish and chips. So all sorts of different things going on. There's an A4 sheet with more information as you're leaving. Kate, again, you're busy today, Kate, is the person organising this for us, thank you. She really needs to know how many people are coming because obviously we're limited for places. So if you are able to come, or again, you want more information, have a chat with Kate. If you could only, you think, well, I'd love to, but I can only do the morning or the afternoon, that's fine. You can just come to what you can, but we do need to know, please. As I said, there is more information there. You pick up the piece of paper as you're leaving. This evening is our evening prayer service at 6:30. And have we had any birthdays this week?
Tomorrow.
You've got a birthday tomorrow! You've been here, wow! Can I ask how old you are?
10.
10? Oh, that's amazing, wow. Have you done anything this weekend to celebrate?
No.
You're going to have cake tomorrow? Yeah, I had to think about that one. Yeah? Good, good. I think on birthday should have a bit of cake. You're waving at me, Joy. Is yours tomorrow as well? Oh, you've got a birthday twin. Are you 10 as well? 10 and a few more. Marvellous. Have you been, are you able to do anything to celebrate or not? Yeah. Oh, out for dinner. That sounds absolutely lovely. Anyone else want to admit to a birthday? No. Okay. What we're going to do is we're going to sing happy birthday. Is that okay, Peter? Can you start us on happy birthday, please, for Euphemia and Joy? Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life. shine as a light in the world to the glory of God the Father. Amen. So I want you to take that candle home, okay? There's a special box for it as well. And the other thing not to forget is you've got your baptism certificate. It's in these envelopes, and all the certificates for the godparents, and a little gift here from the church for you to enjoy playing with when you're at home, okay? And I'm going to leave them on that table for your parents to gather up on their way out. I think Paige's going to make, give them one more round of applause. Now, I think you might need help with this, but we need to blow the candle out now. Great, well done. Do you want to sit down and keep on that warming? And we're all going to stand to receive God's blessing. The God of hope, fill you all with joy and peace in believing. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. And may we all go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.